Welcome back to Energy and Cleaning. I am so excited to be cleaning these pillows with you here today. It is super easy. It is a three-step process. You do not need a washing machine. However, if you would like to wash them in a washing machine, I will link that video in the description box below. But my personal opinion, what I'm about to show here, this three-step process is even better than the washing machine and dryer method. We are going to clean, we're going to remove stains, and we're also going to sanitize and disinfect. Also, if you have large pillows, like king size ones like this, it's very difficult to put them in your washing machine. Am I right? So last night I was putting my five-year-old to bed and I smelled something real funky. I think it was a lot of drool that had accumulated here in his pillow right here, and I thought I need to make this video. One thing that I would do is on each pillow there usually are washing instructions. Let me just show you what I mean by that. Let's see, I'm gonna flip you around. Instructions, care instructions right here. So if you're wanting to wash them, this is one place to check as well. Yes, each pillow has them. All right, so let's talk about first things first. A lot of skin, just like on your couch or your furniture, accumulates up in these pillows, just like on your mattress. Yes, any videos that I think would be helpful in conjunction to this, I'm gonna link in the description box below. Skin's all up in here. So I'm gonna take my vacuum, I'm gonna suck all that skin up that I can't even see and any other sort of debris or disgustingness. If you don't have a vacuum like this, just take it outside, beat it like you would a rug like they did in the olden days or that you might do right now. And then we're gonna move on to step two. All right, now that we got that all sucked up, I actually took them outside too and just kind of beat them in the wind. I don't know, just to get everything out of them as much as I possibly could. Okay, now to remove any sort of stains, you're gonna take some hydrogen peroxide. Make sure that you, there's a reason that this is in a brown bottle, because when it hits light, it activates and starts to break down ingredients inside of the hydrogen peroxide. Okay, so you're gonna take a little bit, there's no exact science to this, you guys, but just do a little bit of hydrogen peroxide, a little bit of Dawn dish soap. This is if you have any particular stains. I didn't see any on the pillows, but I just want to show you for demonstration purposes. You can do this on carpeting. You can do this on a mattress. It works amazingly well. All right, so we'll assume this is an old toothbrush. We'll assume that's a stain, and you're just going to rub oh so gently. Blot as needed. If it's a dried in stain, I would do this. If it's a stain that you just put on there, I would blot first, and then I would engage in this to get that stain up. And this should clean up anything. I've cleaned up cat puke. I've cleaned up cat poo also with this method right here for removing stains. All right, now that we got that all done here, we have taken all the yucky skin cells out of it as best as we could, or any other sort of debris. We've de-stained our pillows. Next step here. This one, I think of all of these steps, is the most important one right here. Not only for having clean pillows, but for sanitary reasons. So I'm gonna go over here, and I have two things that I wanna show you. Oh, I got three things that I wanna show you. All right, guys, I'm pumped up. Are you pumped up? Good. Okay, first things first, right here, I have rubbing alcohol in here. This is amazing because it dries quickly, and when you leave it on, it will disinfect and sanitize your pillow. So if you have a funky smell, it will help kill any of the bacteria. This is my son's right here in this pillow. Another option for you, I love this product. Now, if it doesn't work the first time that you use it, I've used this in my garbage can outside and I had to do a couple coats of it and it worked just fine. It killed all the bacteria, but there are instructions on the back for sanitizing versus disinfecting. Disinfecting, basically, you're leaving it on much longer, giving it more time to kill any of the bacteria that's on here. But this is for fabric and air care. I should put this in my description box as well if you're interested in it. The other option, this one is my favorite, but I wanted to show you the others in case you wanted a more all-natural approach. If you found that this didn't help, you wanted a commercial product, this is good basically anywhere in your house. Again, I've used that for cat stuff. Febreze, you guys. But let's look back here on the ingredients. This is what's most important and most interesting. Okay, do you see right, where is it? Oh, it's right in front of my face. I'm looking through the camera. Contine agua, alcohol, are the first two ingredients. So water and alcohol are the first two ingredients in this product right here. And in my experience, it smells awesome. So it's kind of like using this. In fact, I'm gonna use both, but this has it all in one. Yes, yes. Okay, so this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go ahead and spray my pillows. And if you, I would let this, you can spray it as much or as little as you want. I'm gonna be pretty generous in my sprays here today. You can see I'm getting it on my bedspread probably too, but it's no big deal. We're gonna spray, this is the really stinky one, you guys. Oh, I felt so bad. I obviously didn't say anything, but I was just thinking, I gotta get that taken care of. This gets deep inside the pillow insert, and you wanna get all of that out. And you're gonna let it completely air dry. I would let this sit for about 10 minutes. If you wanna use it quickly, pop it in the dryer. That's also gonna help kill some of the bacteria with the heat. So we're gonna do this. And then I'm gonna go in with my Febreze just for extra measure because it does make it smell really, really nice. And I do this probably about every 3 months or so. It's nice having the kids. They kind of prompt me to it with the smells that are going on. Be generous with it because you want to make sure it gets in the padding of the pillow. So I do think this is a much more detailed approach, and it's actually much easier than putting in your washer and dryer, but it's just nice to do both. And again, the Febreze is awesome because main two ingredients, water, alcohol. Yes. So for me, I'm actually probably going to pop these in my dryer here because my kids are going to be taking a nap here shortly. I'm gonna make sure that I let this product sit for at least 10 minutes so that it can properly disinfect all the bacteria that's inside here. I think this is a big reason that people don't use Lysol wipes properly. I made a video on that as well, is because they put it on the counter, the wipe, and then they dry it up. You don't wanna dry it up. You wanna leave it nice and wet so it can properly kill all that bacteria that's housed in here. And people sweat throughout the night and it's dark. Dark, water, moisture is a breeding ground for bacteria, just like the inside of your shoes. You could do the same method with your shoes, yes? All right, good deal. Okay, I hope that you found this video helpful. If you did, make sure that you give it a thumbs up. Subscribe for my newsletter if you want to learn how to turn your passions into profits. And I will see you, my friend. Ooh, and be sure to share this out with a friend that you think that this may be helpful for, whether on Facebook, email, text, you name it. See you in the next one.